aircraft.
But we do know that at Bagram, because of the nature of the base there, the planes have to take off at a much steeper gradient than a normal 747 would have to. And we also know it was carrying 5 armoured vehicles being taken out of Afghanistan as part of a drawdown of US forces, each one of those weighing 27,000 pounds. So, as you say, the most likely scenario may well turn out to be that simply that the cargo, being so heavy, was displaced on the plane, and it was in such a steep gradient, that's what flipped it.
Cargo airplanes, when you load a cargo airplane, they have what's called a loadmaster. He happened to be on this particular flight when the airplane crashed. But it's his responsibility to ensure that the cargo is distributed properly and properly secured. One of the things that investigators are going to have to find out is how they secured those vehicles and the other cargo, and to see where those vehicles were loaded in the aircraft. That aft shift, that is, if one vehicle broke loose, it could be a cascading effect causing other vehicles to break loose, go to the back of the airplane. But as you saw in the video, the nose then fell through or came forward, and then the cargo that moved back will now move forward. So that creates a real instability for the pilots to try and control.
Right, and we should remember the 7 Americans lost their lives in this, and our condolences to all of their families. Almost appalling tragedy and quite extraordinary footage. Thank you very much indeed to you, Greg Feith, for joining me. And we'll be right back.